Hi, I'm Quintin. I'm playing Volgarr the Viking. It's a old-style Ghosts and Goblins game made by just a few dudes who kickstarted it a couple years ago. I think it's out on the Xbox One, too. I think on the PC. Join me! Just yell at me if the
audio is loud.
This game is hard as fuck. So it's a lot like Ghosts and Goblins or Ghouls and Ghosts, where you only can take one basic hit and then you die, but you can get armor to absorb some hits and get some extra power. But the problem is, once you lose that armor, you lose some of your attack abilities, which sucks. Fuck. So, see, I just lost that shield because I'm an idiot, and then I just died because I'm an idiot. Thankfully, since this is the first level, they just kind of give you a shield. It's nice. You can see the shield kind of blocks one hit from it. Green dudes take one hit, blue dudes take two hits. Cool Viking helmet. Picked up treasure off that corpse. Shoot, man. Jeez. Alright. No, I can get up here. Well, that helped again. So that's something, I guess. I really love this mechanic of being able to use the spears as a platform. Wait, 11. Ah! That's great. Okay, I see. A while since I've played this. I think I ended up only getting to the second level, actually. First few times I played this, and then gave it up, because it's fucking hard, man. Guys are... Yeah, Flaming Sword. That's right. Shield, so that's gonna fuck me with this guy. Good. I didn't realize I had to be standing at the exact proper depth to not get hit by this clip. Yeah, Flaming Spear. Doing all right here. Means I'm gonna self completely and fuck this all up. Look at this, I got the Flaming Sword already. That's great. Alright. Sorry about that. I didn't actually realize this. Doing the double jump with the Flaming Sword actually gives... That's kind of... If you ever played something like Super Ghouls and Ghosts where... oh shit. All of them. Super Ghouls and Ghosts, where you actually get more attacks with the newer armor. So when you get the gold armor, you actually get a magic attack. Your attacks are upgraded. Kind of a lot like that. It's nice. Oh, okay. Did not realize you guys were chatting. Hi, everybody. Fuck you, Kevin. And let me see if... Matt, is my... my audio is low. I'm almost peaking. I can turn it up. Oh, I can't turn. Oh, I could turn it. Shit. There we go. Let me know if that's better, Matt. This better? That?
I don't know.
This headset kind of fucking sucks, so I don't know. Maybe it's because it's not next to my mouth? I don't know. Let's try that. Let me know. Am I too soft, Kevin? Tell me. It says yes. Okay. It doesn't help that I live on a highly trafficked street and trucks have been driving down all day. Also, I mumble, which... Yeah, I said that. I can get past this thing. I'm not going to be able to. Motherfucker! Oh, you lose the helmet and the flame sword? Well, now I'm just fighting. So. Off. Focus here. Slaughtering lizard man. As a Viking would. Not need more power armor. Remember when you almost didn't buy Fallout? Remember that? Also, I really hope you guys like watching me play the first part of a level over and over again. For 60 minutes. That's probably. Or I guess, or like 36 minutes. That up. Power up. What an ass. Yeah. The design in this game is like, first level wise, it's still hard as shit. And there are tooltips, but yes. The level's like very clearly designed. Have you get all the health pickups and then figure out what that stuff does. So, you know, you've encountered those blue guys and they're already two hits earlier in the level, but once you get the flame sword, got all of those pickups, you find out that. Oh, okay, I get an extra hit, because that was good. Pretty clever. I feel like games don't do that as well as they used to. Maybe I'm just an old man. No. I'm just a simple Viking. Yeah, fuck that plant. Not like copulate with that. Those guys are still rough. Really aggressive. I get for doing well. Oh!
All right.
If I could have gotten the Super Nintendo working, Kev, I was going to play ActRaiser and ActRaiser 2, funny enough. But I couldn't, so... Probably for the best, honestly. Actors, such a piece of shit. Ooh. That's what I get for checking chat. Oh god. Don't remember what the money does in this game at all. I think maybe I can buy shit between levels, but so apparently if I press up, I can cock back the spear, but I still have to press the button. Although at that point it's just the attack button, so then I don't have to move my finger. I'm sure you guys are terribly interested in the controls of the game. Whee! Flame sword. Alright. Also, did you guys have Twitch accounts before, or did you literally just make them so you could start chatting? If you made them to start chatting, thanks, guys! So I know I need a thing here. What happens? Right. I'm just gonna pretend you didn't have a Twitch account, Matt, and say, thanks, buddy. Good friend. Garbage. Yeah! Spin jump. I guess the move there is to land and then charge up a spear and throw, but too dumb for that. Not how I roll in Volgarr the Viking. Like, it would have also been the move here, because I have to plant that, too. Those fucking Spelunky-style Indiana Jones bullshit things. Awful. I hate you too, Matt. I don't know what I just did. But I got an achievement for it. Fuck off. Really? Gotta power up, lose a power up. Alright, that's. I can put emoticons in this chat room. Real kisses. Kisses.gif. Mead has a bunch of weird, very specific emoticons, but it might be because he's a Twitch partner. Seeing shit. But he has several emoticons that are just his head. Wouldn't subject people. Well, maybe I would. It's pretty funny. Further spikes here. You know, I'm not doing terribly. Maybe I shouldn't say that. It's gonna die, but. Oh, I remember this fucking part. I hate it. Hate it so much. Do this the way it was meant to be played. Don't have a powered up spear. Doesn't matter. Power up. Oh yeah, that's actually how I'm supposed to handle that. Fuck off. Game's real hard, you guys. Spare. Alright. God, really? Good news, Matt. I'm recording this, so if you fuck off, I'll just send you the file. Although fucking OBS records as F4V, so I have to run it. Go there. Have fun with that, buddy. Now I'm pretty conscious of sighing and saying fuck off. Pretty sure that's my mantra. If I was student of transcendental meditation. I don't know, man. It's no belching drum kit. Oh, Kevin's at soundboard. Yeah, I don't know if you know this story, Kevin. So, Matt used to do the, Matt used to do the narration for the Simply Interactive videos, and one of our coworkers decided it would be hilarious. It wasn't. To make a, like a drum machine's, make a drum machine set, of Matt's weird throat and gurgly noises. Because his throat gurgles a lot. But, Oh, it was an album? Is that what it was? Wait, did he really make an entire album? Where does the motherfucker find time to do shit like that? Nobody got time for that. Right. You do say weird stuff, Matt. But at least it's more interesting. Is this? Fighting. Sighing. Saying fuck off. Oh, I seem to have a couple more viewers, so hi everybody! Enjoy me sucking at Volgarr the Viking. These guys are just gonna keep coming. Deal with them. Yeah, but he doesn't need cool gold armor. He's a Viking. He just takes the hits. Down. There we go. Oh, right. For the shit. I think I actually. Oh, right. Yeah, okay. And that knocks you back. It does, especially if he's going to an eyes wide shut sex party. Definitely. Sword the shit and immediately fuck up. That's what I do. That's how I live my life. Boss fight, it's a don't. Oh, I do sort of. Oh, yeah. Great. Oh, God. All right. Man, this there's no checkpoint. There's no checkpoint in this level. I gotta do the whole thing again. Bit rough. Fuck. Happen. Yeah, I'm doing real well. Real well. Oh right, I don't have the fucking plane thing. So I'm playing like garbage, I forgot. Proper direction. Ooh, I was close. What's up, aren't I? Hey, I did it! Alright. I think I got this boss. Am I gonna beat him without a masquerade mask? I just can't get greedy, I think. Gotta be patient. It often goes with video game bosses, I guess. And hit the... Oh, apparently if I get too close to his face, I lose armor. Great. Awesome. I love this. I love this game. Game is good. Fucker! I don't think I actually labeled this explicit, so I can only assume that the other viewers are 7-year-olds. He's saying the word fuck a lot. Channel. Appropriately. Getting kind of reckless now. It's okay. I'm gonna do it. Fuck! God damn it! The worst part is everything is just my fault. It's not. Game is hard, but fucking idiot. I want to see what's up there. I mean, I kind of don't. That was stupid. That was dumb. Really, really dumb. Thinking about the swearing, I remember when I first started playing this game, playing in the office, and I used to be in the other room watching TV. She said, I don't like whatever game you're playing because it seems to make you very angry. Yell fuck off a lot. Yeah, it's pretty much this game. Doing great. It's really frustrating too, because every mistake is my fault. The controls are super precise. Patterns are pretty easy to remember once you encounter them. I'm just real fucking bad at this game. Thought for some reason that your shield, your back shield could block stuff, but I got something wrong with that. Oh shit! I can jump. Doing better than it was last round, so that's something, I guess. Double jump there. Oh my god. Oh, jinxed myself. Time is up. I got time. I'm gonna beat this fucking level. Do it. Sound of the shield in this game. Sound design in general is pretty good. Kind of squishy noises when you hit enemies, and the weapon noises. Like them. Man. My fault. All my fault. Sometimes I wonder if it's added pressure. People watching? Or if I just always bet this bad a video. Probably always just been this bad a video. Myself. Start this section over again. Oh shit! You have the wooden shield, it just takes it right down.
imagine. Fuck. Oh god.
All right. Do 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 do. Too close to that splash damage. Fucked up. Lizard piece of shits.
Oh my god.
Y'all ready for this? Fucking up a storm here. Seems to me that there are always two choke points for me at this level. That pass point and this point here. Be real careful there. Gotta get my other mic set up too. Yeah. Oh, so that guy is not the red guy that I think he is. Alright. Bottom. It really is like a European. Just over and over, missing the exits. Getting honked at by your angry European. Don't fucking jinx me, Keezer. Don't. And in your bones.
Really? Motherfucker!
Ugh!
I can't get the distance on that guy. There's always a lighthouse. There's always a mat. There's always a failed run of Volgarr the Viking. See, you. This is on you, Matt. This is all on you. This run, though, this run's gonna be different. I can feel it. This time, feel good. This actually reminds me of a story. But it's related to Super Ghouls and Ghosts, which is a very similar game. But when I was living in San Diego, one of my roommates, had her boyfriend come down from LA with his friend whose name was Crazy Larry. I never learned his last name, and I really wish I would, because he was an ex-felon who, upon introduction, told me about the awesome form of martial arts he knew, which involved... Yeah, fuck yeah. It involved, like, short sticks, I'm not sure, like, kind of like batons, and, he just kind of looked me straight in the eye and was like, fucking just hit me in the shins as hard as you can, just hit me in the shins! And he made me hit him in the shins. I looked at my roommate and she was like, man, dude, it says. But anyway, we had a Super Nintendo in the living room. With a few games, but Super Ghouls and Ghosts was one of them. And, Crazy Larry is like Madonna, he does need it. We're in bed, and Crazy Larry was sleeping in the living room. So I hear, you know, the cartridge noise rustle into the Super Nintendo, and I hear the Capcom start screen. And, Super Ghouls and Ghosts is a hard game. But also, when you're super uncomfortable that there is a man named Crazy Larry sleeping in your house, you kind of don't want him playing a really hard Super Nintendo game. So as I'm falling asleep, I just hear this insane 6-foot-tall ex-felon who was forcing me to hit him in the shins just 3 hours earlier, yelling like, "Fuck! God fucking! Fuck! God fucking!" Man, I was having a good run until I was telling this story. He just started pacing up and down the hallway outside of my room, and then would go back and play. And scary. Scary time in my life. I don't know what happened to Crazy Larry. I wish I did. I don't know if he ever beat the second world of Super Ghouls and Ghosts. I was convinced of it. 100. No, I did not walk out anyway. And he was gone in the morning, like a mystical elf. Came into my life to bring me fear. And then he was gone. not gonna talk. I'm not gonna talk. I'm gonna say something and then lose immediately. Kinda hang. Now I don't have any hits. He's gonna kill me. But the snake will. Nope. Oh, fuck.
Alright.
What do you guys think? This is gonna be my last run. If I do it, I do it. Dies, he dies. Motherfucker. Carrying the stress on my shoulders, I can feel it just tightening up. So concerned with hitting the red guy that I did not even see super plant spore. Man. Ah, fuck. At least I got rid of it. That's the most important. Up, over, up, over. And that. Feeling good. Pretty damn good. Fuck, I did it again. I fucking did it again. Cannot believe it. God damn it. I'm gonna call it there. Thanks everyone for watching. I appreciate it. It's been fun. Beating the first level of Volgarr the Viking was just not meant to be, apparently. But I think I'm gonna try it again, maybe next week. Yay! Yeah, I know. It's I want to see you do it, though, Matt. I want to see you be Volgarr the Viking, because I don't think you can. I don't think you can do it, buddy. Believe it. Yeah. For those of you who may be watching who don't know who I am, you should check out bubblegumcult.com. I got a podcast with Matt, who is in the chat. We talk about some bullshit, pop culture bullshit. Check it out. It's pretty good. That's okay. That's me signing off.